Hello everybody, it's Forever Sims. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another part of Let's Play Magical Diary. So in the last one, I ran a little bit longer than I was supposed to. Oops, we went to detention, we got the talk, we planted some flowers, and now it is Saturday, October 5th. Alright, Virginia's yawning. So are you and William working on your plan to take over the class today? Well, we can't today exactly. Why not? He's not here. What do you mean he's not here? It's Cider Day, the big apple festival in the next county over. Most of the upperclassmen go there on field trip. It's over an hour away, so they have to leave early. Why didn't we hear about it? Freshmen aren't allowed. It's a privilege. Well, excuse me. What's an apple festival? Oh, even I know this. Come on, girl. A harvest fair. Don't you have those where you come from? I mean, we don't have them where I come from. I just know what they are. I don't know. They get a big old-fashioned cider press, set it up on the green so everybody can watch the apples being crushed, and they sell it jugs of it. There's lots of food. Apple donuts, apple sausages, apple upside down cake, caramel apples, squash apple soup. Well, it's not all apples. Big bake sale, craft sale, art contest, and there's fiddlers in the day. Okay. And then a contra dance in the evening. From the look on Ellen's face, she has no idea what a contra dance is, but she's not gonna ask. Ellen, I don't know what it is either, so like, we're in this together. So the seniors are going off to a dance without us. Well, it doesn't matter. What should I do today? Let's go to the mall because I want to window shop. What should we do? Let's go to the magic store. Yes, yes, yes. This branch of the mall looks like a dead end. There's only one shop front and it's blacked out with a coming soon sign on the door. But as I get closer, a patch of wall blurs and shimmers to reveal a second door marked with a star. Marvelous magical accomplishments. Oh, look at this. What should I look at? How much money do I have? We have glasses, protective gear, furry set. Okay, oh, too far, okay, yikes, who, well, anyways, I'm thinking that we should get glasses because we are Eliza Pancakes, and of course, the icon and queen herself, Eliza Pancakes, has glasses, so I mean, adding an air of sophistication as well as making it easier to read the fine print of an old faded magical tomb. Smart plus 5, cost $10. Let's do it. Oh, there's our money. I see it. It's down here. Cool. You purchase glasses. In order to gain the benefits of your item, you'll have to wear it. Fun! Okay, what else do we got? I want a wand. It's an adorable fairy godmother wand. Oh, it adds magic. That's so cool. We can't afford it, but it's cool. Oh, this is just a normal wand. Okay, this one gives you plus 2, the other one gives you plus 5. I get it. I'm seeing it. What's this do? Improves your understanding of the physical attribute. Blue magic plus 40? Whoa. Okay, then. I kind of want a wand, but I think we'll wait. Obviously until we can afford it. We're gonna save up and see like what kind of stuff we can get. An amulet, black magic plus 30. Okay, I'm gonna leave now, but like, wow, I didn't realize there was so much to buy. Okay, after dinner, I'm walking back to my room with Ellen and Virginia when I notice a small box sitting in front of the door. Another box? Oh, not again. She pulls back a foot to kick the offending object, then pauses. Hey, Eliza, this one's for you.
Is it from Bob Pancakes, my love? Me?
I peer down at the box. Sure enough, it says to Eliza in flowing letters. Nothing about who sent it. So, is this another one of Donald's tricks? Why would he send it to me? Because you're gonna get married, okay? Let's open it. I don't know why anyone would send me a present, but I don't know why anyone would send me a prank either. Let's see what it is. I pick it up, too heavy for clothing. It opens up here. It's, oh, it's a pie. Well, God bless. Cool. A golden flaky pastry lattice covers a filling of spiced fruit, probably apple. But how did it get here? Some upperclassmen must have brought it from the festival, I guess. Oh, maybe it's from William.
No, Virginia, that's Ellen's man. I would never.
Why would he be sending Eliza a pie?
Yeah, don't worry, Ellen. I don't think so either.
What, our Eliza isn't good enough to send a pie to? Yeah, come on, Ellen. Jeez, Ellen looks away. Oops, Virginia doesn't know about Ellen's crush on William, does she? He would probably have left a note if it were him. Maybe it was Isabel taking pity on us, poor freshmen. Do we have a fridge or anything? Nope, you're just gonna have to eat it. You can't eat a whole pie. Eat the whole pie, share it with roommates, or throw it away. We'll share it. I'm a good friend. Of course not. We'll share. Let's go back to the cafeteria and find some plates and forks. Woo. I'm not sure. I don't know if I like apple pie. I've never eaten it. Ellen, do you ever leave your house? Like, how have you never had apple pie? Girl. Virginia gets it. What? How can you never had apple pie? That's like a requirement of American culture. I'm not even American and I've had apple pie. Aren't you supposed to be from which culture? I'm American first. I grew up here just as much as you guys did, you know? Anyway, if you aren't sure, this is the perfect time to try some, right? If you don't like it, Virginia will eat your share.
You bet. I am Virginia. In this moment, I am Virginia.
We split the pie amongst us, and it is delicious. I'm assuming Ellen liked it then. Good for her. Oh, inventory! Glasses! Put it-
She looks so cute!
I'm dead. I'm so dead. Oh my god, that's adorable. That is adorable! Next week, let's do this! What should I do this week? Okay, let's take a look. We need more red magic. Blue, black, white. Gym, maybe? Our stress is pretty high, but I'm gonna do gym. Right. We're doing everything but green because our green is OP as heck. So, cool. That's the plan. Red magic. Success. We learned a spell. Breeze moves air around the caster's current square, creating a gentle breeze. Fun. Oh, it's morning. As I cross the campus on my way to breakfast, I notice there's a lot of campus people standing around here. What's going on? Hello, Eliza Pancakes, right? I turn to see Minnie Cochran, a freshman from Butterfly Hall I've only met in passing. Her hair is colored like cinnamon and her eyes could be called chocolate. If you're Virginia and obsessed with food, oh, I am. Hi.
You're one of Virginia's roommates. She's a lot of fun, isn't she? I've been meaning to get to know you for a while. I'm sorry, I should have done more.
Oh, she's so sweet. She's probably fake as hell, but it's fine.
Iris Academy is a wonderful place, but sometimes the powerful forget how small the magical world is. They don't always do the best job introducing the newcomers. That's one of the things I want to change. We need class-wide events early in the year. Not just parties, but a chance to learn about each other and all of our different customs. That would help prevent misunderstandings, don't you think? Before I can say a word, she continues. If you have any questions or you need help with any of your spells, you can find me in the library every weekend. Also, the teachers sometimes list extra credit earn merits.
I need that! Yes!
She extends her hands to me, and by reflex, I take it.
I hope I can count on your vote. I have many ideas I want to put into practice.
My vote? Sure.
Great.
I mean, her hair is gold, so that's why. After shaking my hand, she releases it to dig into a bag she's carrying at her side and hands me a bit of yellow construction paper cut in the shape of a hand. It has Minnie Cochran for president written on it and a straight pin pushed in and out through the top.
You don't have to wear the badge, of course, but they're traditional, and sometimes it's important to respect tradition. See you later. Remember, the library.
She knows we're in trouble. She knows we got 10 demerits. She's like, you need my help. Yes, I do. She waves and hurries off to her next target. Politics certainly looks like a lot of work. Not for me. Hooray, we got blue magic. True sight allows the caster to see through illusions in the current location. How fun. And now we're on the grounds again. Campaigning is in full swing. All the candidates, not just in my year, but the upperclassmen too, have taken up positions on the main quad, calling out everyone who passes and handing them colorful bits of paper. It's loud and crowded and confusing. Some of the older candidates are spraying magic sparkles over their heads to try and draw more attention to themselves, which just makes it worse. Yeah, this sounds like a hot mess. Angela for president. Kurgan for secretary.
Vote for Jacob.
I'm buffeted from place to place and decorated with pins and ribbons, mostly from people I don't even know in elections I'm not eligible to vote in. Class starts to sound like a welcome relief. I'm so horrible at reading. Black magic. Success. Look at us go. Inscription. Write or remove words from a target object. Okay. Cool. White magic. Success. Ooh, got three. Empathy reveals the emotional state of a target. Interesting. And we're at the gym to get strong. One strong, one stress. Alrighty. We're breezing through. After activities on Friday, each class has a scheduled time to come to the gym where the officer candidates will make their final speech before elections. Since we can't vote in the senior elections, there's no reason for us to have to listen to their speeches or vice versa. The freshman slot is the last one in the day. First up, there are the candidates for freshman class president. Minnie Cochran climbs to the stage, looking bright-eyed and enthusiastic, and says a bunch of stuff about offering a helping hand to other students. Everyone applauds. Then Suki Sato wanders up the stairs, talking about how she found a caterpillar once that turned into a lizard instead of a moth or something like that. It's a little hard to follow. Oh, and apparently the spirits told her to run for president. Or some spirits. She's not sure which one. Alright. Everyone applauds, but not as loudly. After that comes the presentations for treasurer. Jacob Blazing. The Blazing Fire dresses up and gives a very brief speech about how money is obviously safe with him. And he knows how to spend it too. Alrighty. We have the same glasses. Everyone claps and some guy even hoots in approval. Little Manuel Arias from Toad Hall is up next. He talks far too quietly for me to hear his entire speech, but I think it was mostly about being a hard worker who respects duty. The applause is polite but muted. At last, it's time for the actual voting. Cool. Everyone lines up, blah, blah, blah. Okay, we're gonna vote. Each student is given a pencil and two pieces of paper containing a list of names for each office. We're gonna go with Minnie and Manuel because Jacob seems like a douchebag and Minnie is cute, so that's how I make my political decisions. After all the votes are counted, we assemble again in the gym for results. The position of freshman class treasurer will be held by Manuel! Yes, boy! And I'm proud to announce that this year's freshman class president will be Minnie. Fun! I'd like to thank you all for your hard work this week. You students are what makes our academy truly great. Teachers will be seeking out newly elected officers later today to discuss their positions. I hope you all have a wonderful weekend. I didn't feel like doing her voice. I'm getting sick, so it's fine. What should I do today? Oh, it's another... Okay, well, let's go study, because didn't she say she'd be in the library? Yeah, today I want to study in the school library rather than my room, so Minnie can give us merits. Compared to the rest of the school, the library is fairly small and unimpressive. There's a slightly outdated set of encyclopedias. Ellen didn't really need to bring her own, and a good collection of foreign language dictionaries, plus two bookcases filled with books about magic and witchy history. Most of the rest looks like fiction, with a rack of popular magazines. The school actually subscribed to those. There aren't that many people in here on a Saturday, but looking around, I see... Hi, Eliza! Hi. Hey, congratulations on winning president and all. Thanks. Do you need help with anything? Help with the merits. Actually, I was hoping you knew a way for me to earn some merits. Oh, I can help you with that. That is, if you don't mind sorting rocks. Rocks? Professional Potsdam? I really can't read. Professor Potsdam recently received a shipment of tumbled rocks for amulet making. Only, they're all mixed up because the magic poor... Okay, they're just rocks. But certain kinds of stones are better for holding spells than others, so they need to be sorted by color and size. It's not difficult, but it will take time. I will do it! Sure. Alrighty. Minnie takes me to see Professor Potsdam, and then I spend the entire afternoon painstakingly sorting shiny pebbles into containers. I do get merits for it, but it's tiresome. Rats. Well, that's cool. Oh, it's Sunday and the sports club is having a meeting, or rather a game, and we're going to see what is going on in that game next time. Very exciting, I know. How great. I hope you guys enjoyed this part and I hope you're enjoying this series. I love it. I know I suck at reading, but like, bear with me. I hope you're all having a super amazing day, and yeah, I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.